We plead the blood of Jesus upon their hearts, minds, bodies, souls, and spirits. We command all manner of evil to be completely dispelled from their lives forever as we shut the door after the demonic evil is dispelled with the blood and blood covenant of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father God, we pray that you will move swiftly upon the Parello, Massarini, Brewster, Quayle, Franz, Falco, Wearson, Pastor Buddy, Gano, Harper, my family and myself, all the Christian saints around the world, and especially those who can hear my voice right now. May they be blessed in the morning when they awake with miracle manna, the fulfillment of Bible prophecy, the latter rain, the economy of our God, the congregation of the North economy, the wealth of the wicked kept up in store for the righteous, pressed down, shaken together, and running over to the abject bondage of misery. Shaken together and running over to end the abject bondage of misery. We boldly come before the throne of grace, covenanting with you for this one thing, Father God. It is your promise. We pray now for its fulfillment. End the economic agony of the laboring saints, Father God, in Jesus' name. Full, binding, positive, heavenly, empowered deliverance from all evil, in Jesus' name. Full, binding, healing, and restoration from infirmities, sickness, disease, cancer, all forms of ailment, and economic disaster. Empowering miracles, one after another, to situate each and every life mentioned in this prayer today unto counter-revolutionary victory, underwritten by good and perfected gifts, which cometh down in the latter rain from our Father God in the kingdom of heaven, in Jesus' name. We all pray. We petition you for this in never-ending resolve. In the name and in the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, sealed irrevocably in the powerful, precious shed blood and blood covenant of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Uh-oh. Each and every person who would attempt to touch and hurt the Christian saints, me and my family, you and your family, the comprehensive totality of all the righteous blood curses written within the 66 overlapping books of the Bible to fall squarely upon the workers of iniquity, the workers of martial law violence. We command dedicated warrior angels created by God to protect the Christian saints in this world to descend face to face with one world order violent bloodlust martial law operatives and judge them severely with the sword of the Lord and the judgment of the congregation of the North for their crimes against humanity and the innocent, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father God, Yahweh, Jehovah Jireh, Yeshua HaMashiach, we hereby present the militant, violent, false balance sins, crimes, and horrors of the Right Paradigm International Order of the Bush Vatican City Crime Family Syndicate. We hereby present the militant, violent, false balance sins, crimes, and horrors of the Left Paradigmed International Order of the Obama, Goldman Sachs, Haman Jew, Tribe of Dan, Synagogue of Satan. They have hijacked our Romans 13 good government. They have replaced it with sin, false balances, lies, horrors, death, rape, misery, bondage, tyranny, and martial law, enslavement. Law enforcement, felony rape and murder, FBI assassination, kidnapping, and drug running, CIA, Catholics in action, domestic deception, false flag events, and genocidal mass domestic assassinational murder teams. Federal Reserve monetary monopolistic high crimes of treason being white-collar Haman Jew killer traitors. They have replaced Romans 13 good government with a melded, total, absolute concoction, seamless, double-aisle, high treason traitor behavior which defies the rule of law, the Constitution, and the Declaration of Independence from all manner of tyranny. Money is the root of all evil, and whosoever is deceived thereby is unwise. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than it is for a Warren Buffett, Donald Trump, Bill Gates, or Edgar Bronfman Jr. to get into the kingdom of heaven. They have hijacked corporate responsibilities. On foreign potentate orders, they have sent all our jobs to third world slave labor marketplaces for corporate profit dens, and then returned products home for the purchasing at union wage prices while making it impossible, because they broke the unions, to buy those products, as the middle class has been purposely destroyed, retirement packages seized, downsized, and then they disappear, leaving Americans homeless, jobless, moneyless, foodless, with no medical or insurance coverages. It is the corporate genocide of the American people from a John Holdren eugenic holocausting perspective. They have taken the people's money from the people's bank, the U.S. Treasury, and they have given all our money on purpose to Wall Street whores, thieves, and desk killers at Goldman Sachs, J.P. Morgan, and Luciferian bankers in U.S. Treasury Haman Jews like Mr. Summers, Geithner, Rubin, designed by Rahm Emanuel Auerbach, Jamie Dimon, Lloyd Blankfein, the 16 Haman Jew Federal Reserve dons and underbosses, while the people, kept in violent bondage by the Haman Jew IRS with Doug Haman Jew Shulman presiding over his newly acquired shotguns, chain guns, Gatling guns, and posse death squad IRS hit teams ready to go into action in 3 months when it begins to get cold again and the people of America are totally broke and unable to move anywhere for safety. Doug Haman Jew Holocaust Gentile Killer Shulman will then move to seize people and their assets, imprison, rape, torture, and kill them there in FEMA concentration camps with their blood libel Blackwater XE shame of the SEAL community, embarrassment of the SEAL community, whores of the SEAL community, bitch of the SEAL community, cowardly bully of the SEAL community, oath taker, and then abridged oath breaker, officer, slumlord, missionless, militant, anti-Christian papist of the SEAL community, Eric Prince, and his Blackwater XE martial law death squadded teams of the IRS, soon to break loose on the poor, broken down, beautiful, but don't tread on me, sweet American people. Father God, Yahweh, Jehovah Jireh, Yeshua HaMashiach, we present to you the despotic hijacked government of the Bush Vatican crime family syndicate and the Obama liar, eggplant, whore, Haman Jew, Tribadan, synagogue of Satan, and all their violent, blood-bathing, blood-lusting, unjust, unrighteous, satanic sins of gross raping, violent injustice against the innocent, the Obama administration. We ask you now, Father God, face to face, send forth, right now, no waiting, warrior angels with the sword of the Lord in their hand to meet the human agents of violent bondage, economic one-world horrors, constitution defiling acts of high treason, and judge them into oblivion for their crimes against living humanity. Sit quietly no longer, Father God. May your right hand remain on your throne no longer, Father God. We offer you, face to face, the sins and martial law death plans of the Bush-Obama left-right paradigm of evil and all their well-dressed nightly news appearancing scum. We offer you communist media death killer Chris Matthews. We offer you false balance, violent, gutless, cowardly, desk killer Mark Potash and Haman Jew bloodbather Abraham Foxman. You are the God of justice, and you demand it everywhere throughout your word. You are the God of the Christian family, and I have read an account of 2,000 years of mass murder in Fox's Book of Martyrs against the Christians and the Jews by the same people who occupy the same positions of hijacked power, who destroy Christian and Jewish humanity at the command of Satan, the prince of the power of the air. Jesus said, greater things than these will ye do in my name, and so we are. We command forth the angels of heaven right now to descend on the workers of iniquity with your corresponding congregation of the north authority, Father God, Yahweh, great I am, Jehovah, Jireh of heaven. We petition you for it all, the good reasons under heaven. For whatsoever man soweth in Satanism and one world order profanity, that shall they also reap. Expedite the proceeding in Jesus' name. It's nice to see Dennis Blair, the martial law Admiral Papa, quit under siege of his own death camp sins. It's nice to see David, martial law betrayer, collapse under the weight of his own oath-breaking martial law sins yesterday in Washington. But we now need the God of heaven to act and to fulfill his word and to fulfill Bible prophecy. We need the God of heaven, the God of the Christian family, the God of the Christians and the Jews, the God of heaven to rise up with the wrath-based protective vengeance of Almighty Yahweh Jehovah Jireh and judge severely the repressive Satanist revived Roman Empire one-world despotic government hijackers who are an affront to your holy name, and to face them off with the sword of the Lord. We command it, we petition you for it, face to face, standing right here, boldly before the throne of grace. I have tens of millions standing right here with me, face to face with you, Father God, petitioning you for your immediate action as we watch the results of your hand's command and warrior angels, face to face, judgment upon the left-right paradigming evil within these United States of America across the board. We pray, Father God, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, sealed irrevocably in the powerful pressure-shed blood and blood covenant of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, and all the saints in agreement said, amen and amen, Father God, you can't deny it. We laid it before you. There it is. Satan, sit down. Shut your mouth. You suck. Jesus is Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, please repeat this prayer after me right now, and you will receive eternal life. Your names will be written in the Lamb's book of eternal life. Here we go. Dear Lord Jesus, like everyone else, I also confess that I also am a sinner. But please forgive me for all of my sins. I accept the fact that God raised his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, from the grave. I believe in, and I trust in, that resurrection power. I accept you right now, Lord Jesus, as my personal Savior and Redeemer from sin. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Forgive me and save me. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for saving my soul. Help me to live for you for the rest of my life. I am washed. I am cleansed in the blood of Jesus Christ. I am saved. Well, my friend, if you just repeated that prayer after me right now in all truth, faith, and honesty, congratulations. Your name has just been forever written in the Lamb's book of eternal life, and you just put the Vatican City, Hora Babylon, and the seven sacraments of death and the eternal lake of fire out of business. During the rare top secret closed session of Congress. Speaking, Nancy Pelosi, the shame of the Italian-American community, and I quote her, "The United States economy will no longer be able to support itself past the end of the second quarter of 2010. At that time, martial law will need to be implemented to restore law and order." All in attendance at that closed, rare, top-secret session of Congress had their lower chin then dropped down to the top of their big toe. The end of the second quarter is the end of June, ladies and gentlemen. 13 days until the end of June. 83 deadly days, 3 months until the Feast of Trumpets, Rosh Hashanah. Goldman Sachs selling their BP shares days before the disaster. The head of BP selling over a third of his stock days before the disaster. Find these people, arrest them, and place them up against the constitutional death penalty. Why would someone do that unless they had inside information? This is a Rahm Emanuel Auerbach, Mossad, CIA, Catholics in action, demolitional false flag event, just like 9/11. And they're making the same type of money thereafter. It is occurring to bring the martial law-infusing collapse of the United States of America, and so that conspirators can make billions. The constitutional death penalty for high treason traitors. Ladies and gentlemen, our office has just learned, as of 5 a.m. this morning, that Microsoft founder Bill Gates and Oracle Corporation Chief Executive Officer Larry Ellison and the long arm of the martial law invasion of your computer information for all martial law authorities, Sun Microsystems CEO Dorian Daley, are up to no martial law good. This is a national emergency. We broke the foundation of this story 28 years ago when Vinod Khosla and Haman Jew, Andy Bechtelsheim, Bill Joy, and Scott McNeely formed Sun Microsystems and worked closely with Bill Gates at Microsoft and Steve Jobs at Apple, and later with all administrative elements of the United States intel and military community on a project called Java X. Java X is the window screen to your computer. It keeps files out, but it is porous and allows anyone into your computer to retrieve all your information if they are connected to the Microsoft, Apple, Oracle, Sun Microsoft, Intel, tech-based law enforcement, military, martial law, a community. Bill Gates and other high-tech one-world Bilderberg Vatican City officials have just returned to their various headquarters from Sitges, Spain, with accelerated eavesdropping and data mining fusion center destined personal information orders. Meant for every person on Earth, especially every human being in the United States with a computer. The rapture of the church, yes, will save us. But the rapture of the church will now save them. Prior to this 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 through 18, historic and worldwide game-changing airlift of all the Christian saints to a messianic Yeshua HaMashiach, Lord Jesus Christ, predetermined airspace destination, we are commanded by God to fight for justice, fight against enslavement, fight for good government, and fight against bad government, as our founding fathers have also commanded. The One World Order enslavers, our eugenic genocidal madmen, are now running scared, faced with violent cold-blooded martial law extinction and scientific sterilization, birth defects, baby and child death, and every manner of violent slavery. The people are now just beginning to bring the criminals to justice. So much so that they're fainting on their face before pagan Satanists and Bohemian homosexual, bisexual, blowjobbing, anal-pumping people like John McCain. Their getaway helicopter rotoblades become jammed and dysfunctional, leaving them stranded from their airborne getaway modes of transportation. Their limos, getaway cars, windows get painted black and thus become undrivable. And some lunatic fired a slug through the private martial law One World Order jet so the banana couldn't compressionize while attempting to reach altitude. And some horrible criminal terrorist, sniper, put a frag in both tires, so David Rockefeller had to remain on the LaGuardia tarmac as 30,000 people stormed the terminal tarmac and turned over his jet Citation that was supposed to carry him away to another victorious evacuation. Not this time, Rockefeller, bitch. The people are coming, and there are only so many mobile chain guns and C-130 Gatling guns to go around to reduce American cities to martial law ruin. The people are coming, and Bill Gates came home with marching orders. All data mining trip words, all Steve Quayle and Alex Jones like website visitors and their corresponding IP name and home address locations are uplinked to fusion centers, which then log you in as a red or blue list concentration camp FEMA DHS bar motel bound enemy of the Vatican City One World Order state. Bill Gates is throwing this into full bore proclamation. You will soon be paid a visit during martial law. You will be violently extracted from your homes. You will be cattle prodded, shot, stunned and shot, airborne, microwaved, chain gunned, or hellfire missiled to death, according to Matthew chapters 10 and 24, and the flashpoint explosion of martial law upon the Constitutional Republic and its people. Ladies and gentlemen, Bill Gates and other high-tech Bilderberg murderers have come home with the following agenda. Accelerate and advance all individuals who conduct themselves online in any way, shape, or form as a dissenter, resistor, Christian, Jew, patriot, veteran, gun owner, or constitutionalist, and immediately place them on the red and blue Final Solution to pick up an extermination list. But Bill Gates and his crew of eugenic pathological mask desk murderers have now been ordered to activate scientifically engineered microviruses to infect every computer in the world of those individuals who are dissenters and resistors of every stripe, purposefully slowing down their computers, freezing your screens up, locking the link boxes in a one-quarter quadrant, and a host of other hostile, criminal, virus, felony, high treason interference of the Bill of Rights, empowered exchange of constitutionally based free thoughts and ideas. More on this tomorrow. Somehow, someway, by some shortwave miracle, you have wired into the most dangerous program on the face of the earth. This has been the last voice of the church age. We're back tomorrow night, where we conclude this week's programming.